So, well, y'all, we getting ready to have this here taco lasagna. And I'm going to show you just how I do it. All right. So let's get started. These are the ingredients and everything that we're going to need for this here lasagna. It's like a Mexican lasagna. Okay. But I put my own little twist in there. Okay. We have some flour tortilla. All right. Now, flour tortilla, sometimes it may get kind of a little smushy, just like regular tacos, but try whichever one you want to try, okay? I have two types of bread here. I have a 5 cheese because it's like Italian dish too, but also it's done with tortillas, flour tortillas. I have some cottage cheese. If you don't want cottage cheese, don't use it. I have some of this Creole season mix. I get this at H-E-B, okay? And I get this taco season, but it's cheesy taco season, and I have about 5 packs because I don't know how much I'm going to need. And I have some ground beef. This is 1.84 pounds. So I don't know how much of this I'm going to be using. All I know, I bought 3 big ones, okay? I have some cilantro because I want some cilantro and I want to have some type of freshness. I have some parsley. I have some green onion to put in there. This already has parsley, cilantro, garlic, a lot of stuff in there, but I just want just a little bit more for a little bit more flavor and taste. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to clean this here up. And then I'm going to chop it up and I'm going to come back when it's time to do my ground beef. So with the cilantro, parsley, and green onion, it came up to 1 cup. 1 cup of all this here, combine it in there together. Okay. And then we're going to do 1 cup of the onions and the Creole mix. It's 1 cup of that. Now that's an H-E-B. Okay, you can find Creole mix in H-E-B. That is good for beans or whatever is good for that. Okay, and then we're gonna put some black pepper in there. And let me see here. Do us about 2 tablespoons of black pepper. Okay, just 2 tablespoons of black pepper. We're gonna add us about 1 tablespoon of salt. Okay, 1 tablespoon of salt. If you don't want the parsley and cilantro and all like that in there, don't put it in there. If you don't want it in there, don't put it in. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to let the seal go ahead on and cook on up. And I'll be back with you, all right? So this is the 3 different types of cheese. Gouda, mozzarella, and sharp cheddar cheese. These are the 3 kinds that I'm going to use. I'm going to grate them up and blend them up together. Okay, so now I'm going to see how much of this taco seasoning I'm going to need. Okay. First 1 pack. Two. Three. Let's see what we got here now. 4. That was not enough.
Let me go ahead on and add the other 2 in there. Okay. All right, so we got this like this here. Okay, now I'm gonna add me a little water in there. Okay, so this right here is 1 cup of water that I'm putting in there now. Cut this here down on 4 because I just want it to simmer now. That's 1.5 cups right there. So that should be good. And all I'm gonna do, I'm just let it simmer on up here. And let me let this here flavor go through here. And then I'm gonna show you what else I'm getting ready to add to it. Okay. Okay, so I have me some picante sauce that I am putting in there, and this is mild picante sauce. And I just put me 1/2 cup in there. I'm gonna see if I wanna add a little bit more to it. I just want enough to where I'm gonna have me just a little taste of picante sauce in there. Okay, so it's like add you some in there. Well, this right here makes a cup of picante sauce. Okay, just a cup of picante sauce. Okay, so this is the picante sauce. The picante sauce is going in. It's gonna give it like a real good taste to it. Okay, so I have this already here like this. So now we're getting ready to go put it in the pan. Okay, so what we're going to do, you put you some ground beef at the bottom of here. Okay, just like you would normally do if you was fixing lasagna. Okay, so you layer that there like that. Then you put your taco shell there. One here, here. And see what you're gonna do, you're gonna layer it. See, cause I want mine's kind of a little thick, like, because I wanna taste it, all right? I really wanna taste it. So I want all of mine to like really be covered up in here really good. Okay, so then you go back and you put you some sauce on top of there like this. Put the meat on top, just like this. Cover it up real good, okay? Cover it up real good. Make sure you cover all the ends up. Okay? Make sure all the ends, don't leave none of the ends exposed. Because what happens when it cooks, it's going to be hard. And what you don't want it to do, you don't want it to be hard at all. Okay? That's what you don't want. You don't want it hard at all. Okay? So, when we do this, then we take and get us some. This right here is just like when you do lasagna. Just like when you're making lasagna. Same kind of way. Just like if you're gonna make lasagna, you do it this way, the same way. You go back in, and I wanted me some of this on mine, some cottage cheese on mine, because I like cottage cheese. Now, you don't want cottage cheese, don't put it on there. Okay, but this is for acquired taste. And I have an acquired taste. And my acquired taste says cottage cheese. That's my acquired taste, says cottage cheese. Because I want that real effect of lasagna. Okay, that's just me. I just want that real effect of it.
And let me see, this right here was a 16 ounce. This is a 24 ounce right here. So do this here like this. Okay, just like this. And then you know it's all gonna be covered up. Okay? Then you know everything's gonna be covered up. Then you go back in, because I mixed all three of my cheeses, I mixed them together. Then you go back in, and you sprinkle you some cheese on top. Okay? Go back in, sprinkle you some cheese on top. Because this is what you do. This right here, I'm only gonna make two layers because it don't need to be that big. We got the cheese. I love cheese. Quite sure everybody else do too. Especially when it melts. It is excellent. Excellent. And if you want to use gluten-free tortillas, get you some gluten-free tortillas and use them. Go back in, repeat, and do the same thing all over again. Do the same thing all over again and just repeat it and do the same thing all over again. Okay? This is the same thing we was doing at first. Just gonna go back in and redo it and do the same thing all over again. Okay? And then you go back in and you're gonna put this on top of here. Okay, this is going on top. This is your end. Okay, this is gonna be our end. We're gonna have the meat on top of here like this. I really don't know because I wasn't paying attention. But then this is the last part we're gonna do right here after we finish layering it with the tamales on top. I don't know how long my phone was without showing this here. I really don't. I guess I get to see it when I see it. But this is the last thing we're gonna put on right here. The last thing that we're putting on here is the meat. Then we're gonna go back. We're gonna put our cheese on top of that. If it was a deeper dish, maybe I could have done a little bit more, but it's not a deep dish. Okay? It's not a deep dish at all. But make sure you cover this here with the cheese and everything good. And we're going to put this in the oven on 365 so it can go ahead on and cook. And I'm going to tell you how long it is going to cook. I'm going about how my cheese melt. It's just like when you're making a Frito pie I make. Okay? We're gonna let this here cool on up in here because it's gonna have to melt. Don't cover it up. Just let it go ahead on and cook. Make sure you have enough cheese everywhere because that's what you wanna taste. Okay? So, oh, it's heavy. I'll be back. All right. I will be back. So, everyone, this is the taco lasagna, Mexican lasagna. And this is how it turned out. And I am going to let it cool off
and then I'll be back to cut it.
So it has had a chance to cool off some, so we're going to cut into it. Oh my goodness. They look so good. Let me have me a little taste of this here. Let me see what it's tasting like. Oh my goodness. God, thank you for the food I'm about to receive. Amen. Lord, I can eat this every day. It's good, y'all. It is good. It's really, really, really good. All I want to tell you, have a beautiful one. Okay. Everything turned out good, as you can see. It is excellent. It tastes good. And it would definitely feed some babies. You understand? Just let it cool off a little bit. Then serve it. Give it a chance to form up. Then serve it. Those children will love it. And you will too. All I want to tell you is, bon appetit, baby. And have a beautiful one.